Hi, I'm Mike.
I'm Don.
And this is the International Space Station Science Garage.
My Russian hat that a guy in Red Square sold this to me. But it's made out of fur, at least I think it's made out of fur. And you can rub this.
Yeah.
And now the
knitting needle. So now there's a charge.
It's charged.
It's charged.
It's charged.
So there's actually a force on that.
There's
that
a force on
we
this.
We can't see it.
No, you can't see it.
Right, all right.
But if we take this.
Typical pepper grinder.
A pepper grinder.
Yeah.
And we're going to go ahead and grind
that?
A little pepper.
You going to tell
me,
would you like some? Tell me when.
Oh, that's plenty, thank you.
Okay.
Okay, now a little Parmesan, please.
How about some battery acid?
No, this is Science Garage.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to charge a knitting needle.
Yeah.
And then we hold that up there.
It's pretty strong pepper. Oh, look at that, like magic.
Yeah.
So all the pepper is being attracted.
Yeah, some of the pepper is attracted and it sticks to the knitting needle. Some of the pepper is being repelled and is pushed away.
Interesting. And some of these are positive and some of these are negative?
Yeah.
You're saying the pepper is positive and negative?
Yeah, it depends on something to do with the grinding process, you know.
Oh, okay. So
that's a subject, another topic.
That's another show.
In space, if a particle was just sitting out here without a lot of velocity, it would get attracted and it would just go straight to the knitting needle and stick.
Right.
Or it might be repelled away, depending on whether it's a positive or negative charge compared to what the knitting needle is.
Gravity. But the way the force works in space is different because of the absence of gravity.
Correct.
There you have it. Thanks, Don.